and this coaching staff very happy.
A great chapter to begin.
Let's go!
Still on his feet. Slip the tackle. 20, 15, 10.
Here we go. The Roosevelt Rough Riders have come on to the field. We are here at the home stadium here, Montgomery Field, and possibly going to be dedicated in the future and a bid to transfer the name to Dickie Guillen Field. We'll see how that plays out. But for right now, this is Roosevelt High School. It's a home game. And game number two, they come in with a big win over Mesa's last week in game number one, or week zero. This is would be the number one game on the list. And across the field, we'll be taking a look at the Lincoln Tigers coming in representing the Northern League. And this is East LA Sports Scene Production bringing you tonight's presentation. And there we go now. We're going to be looking at the captains coming out to meet in the center of the field. And again, we are still in the COVID pandemic situation. And of course, the cloud hanging over all of us here as citizens of the country is the pandemic. But anyway, there's been a way to overcome that situation from last year of 2020. This is 2021. Today is August the 27th, 2021. Beautiful day here in Southern California. High of 91 degrees here at game time, dipping into the lower, we'll call it the high 70s, maybe 75, 77 degrees at game time. There you see number one for the Roosevelt Rough Riders at captain as the quarterback, James Cortez. And he is going to be working on tossing the coin or working to call the actual coin toss. There you see the referee taking the toss. And we're going to switch over now to our chief videographer, Mr. Frankly Robles, present and accounted for. And Mr. Robles, commander, it is all yours. Our crew tonight will be Frankie Robles as our videographer.
Ricky, what's your last name?
And Ricky Cimental, a student here at Roosevelt High School, no stranger to East LA Sports Team Productions, as he pitched in to help us with the game that was played here during what we call the season that they allowed to have some games where it was a very partial schedule, and we did the play-by-play game of Bell versus the Roosevelt Rough Riders right here on the same field. So we're set to go. It's just about ready for kickoff at 7:01, right on time. And we'll get you the starting lineups as soon as we find out who will be receiving and who will be kicking. So stand by, but we're all set to go here at Roosevelt High School. Thanks for watching. And of course, we're going live to videotape. And it will be on our website at eastlasportscene.com. And again, very thankful to have a sponsor here for the City of Los Angeles Business Source East Los Angeles region. Our good friends there, Ruben Sanchez and Ralph Carmona. Ralph is a graduate of here of Roosevelt High School. And we have to say Ruben Sanchez, graduate of Garfield. So they make up the Brain Trust at the East Los Angeles Business Source. And they are operated by Barrio Planners Incorporated, BPI, and they provide a wide range of services to the business community. And its primary function is to provide entrepreneurs and small business owners the needed tools to make their business a success. And again, located in the city of Los Angeles, and they are open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. And let's see, you can find them at area code 323-264-9020. That's 323-264-9020. And let them know you heard and saw the announcement on East LA Sports Scene.
Cotero.
And okay, here we go for Roosevelt. It looks like they're going to defer as they did last week against Maces, and they really took care of business against Maces last week. That's the Maywood Academy for Center for Enriched Studies, and they're located, of course, in the city of Maywood. That was last week. This is this week now. Lincoln High School ready to receive in white gold helmets. Roosevelt Rough Riders in their very, very distinctive gold with the maroon numbers and gold helmets. So here we go. We're set to kick off. And there it is. It's going to go end over end. And it's Blancarte is the quarterback, but he's also on special teams. He's got going left. He's got a block. Still going up on his feet and then brought down roughly, let's call it, at about the 45-yard line unofficially. Okay, good kickoff return there, and special teams doing their jobs. It's Ivan Blancarte, quarterback for the Lincoln Tigers, and he is a senior. He's had himself an outstanding career there. And again, unfortunately for last year, season really wasn't much of anything for the players. They could not really perform at their highest level of play. Again, August 27th, 2021. Time is 7:05. We're just underway here. First quarter, 12 minute quarters in play. Here you go. Blancarte, Watkins, the fake, the pitch. It comes back over to the running back. Three, and he's going to be brought down here on the carry. Does not get very much yardage. Penalty against Lincoln, possibly holding. And he'll be charged with, let's see, number three was Jaden Rattay, R-A-T-T-A-Y. He's a junior, 5'11", 150 pounds. First penalty of the game goes against the Tigers, first and 15. And starting lineups here is quarterback Blancarte, number 22, Andre Watkins, a tremendous power runner. Number four, we have also listed James Kova, and number one, Karan Johnson. Let's see who's in this. The backfield there for Blancarte gives it to Watkins. Breaks a tackle, still on his feet, stops, and then going to be brought down by a host of Roosevelt Rough Riders. Let's see who's in there on that stop for the Riders. Just underway here, 11:22 left in the first quarter. Look for on defense, Alexander Arroyo and Carlos Vasquez for the Riders. Linebacking core, second and 20. Blancarte rolling right as a receiver. Oh, in and out of the hands of number one, Karan Johnson. And it's going to bring up, let's see, third. We're looking for the down markers way on the other side of the field. Sun is a kind of in our eyes there. Third, it's long, third and 20 for the Tigers in white and gold. Up on the line here for the Tigers, number 71, Michael Ruiz, 54, Carlos Florida, 52, Ryland Lucio, and there's Blancarte, throws it complete. Oh, incomplete, check it.
On the coverage, number three, intended for number four.
Oh, Quesada in on the coverage, number three for the Riders. He goes both ways, as do many of the players here on both squads. It's going to bring a fourth and 20. And let's see who's back in there to punt. And that will be Watkins as the special teams punter. Number 22 on his jersey. Very, very well-recruited player. He's a senior. And Watkins semi-spiral. And it's dropped. Picked up. And then spun down for... looks like Andrade, maybe a gain of a couple of yards. Jared Andrade three, on the return. And let's give you the starting quarterback. Number one, James Cortez. Number three, wingback Eddie German. And we have number two, Julian Quesada. And number six, Isaiah Wright. Isaiah Wright.
Here comes the
and number five, Jared Andrade. Look for those in the backfield up front. James Trujillo, number 40. Osman Cerezo, 56. Alejandro Ibarra, 50. Daniel Butron, 55. Freddy Perez, 54. Daniel Cueva, 75. And number 80, Ben Salinas. Starting lineup for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. in motion. Oh, and then he stopped.
Whistle before the snap. Penalty will be against.
Penalty against the Riders.
Roosevelt.
Double wing formation for head coach Aldo Parral here at Roosevelt High School. And very comfortable with that formation. And he has taught it well to his players here. Double wing and a lot of activity in the backfield. It's a run-oriented game, and sometimes passes are mixed into the playbook. Okay, Cortez at quarterback. In formation, out of formation. Long count. Pitch, here we go, crossways. Number two's got it. And he lunges forward for a little bit of extra yardage after he was hit.
Julian Quesada.
Julian Quesada, he's a senior, 5'10", 180. Good size there for a running back. As night falls, approaches here at Roosevelt High School. The 2021 season is underway. This is game two. Roosevelt Rough Riders winning game number one against Maces last week. And now taking on Lincoln. Again, the Maces was a substitute team for the Carson Colts out of the Marine League. And we'll refer you to our website at eastlasportscene.com to listen, to read in how Roosevelt was able to get that game off. Ah, Quesada again, following his blockers. Yes, it looks like he was down. The ball popped loose. And it looks like he has enough for the first down. He's close to it.
Injured player, timeout called for the injured player.
A player down on the field for Lincoln. He's getting up slowly. Let's try to get a number on him. And that's number 50.
And
he corresponds to Daniel Chihuahua. Chihuahua, state in Mexico. Daniel Chihuahua, surname. Okay, he's off the field. There's a substitute that's brought in for him. And we'll try to get you the Lincoln defense. Number four in the cornerback spot is Jose Cova. Number 11 is Joshua Sosa. Number seven, Ivan Plancarte or Ivan Plancarte. Third and one, a long one. Cortez pitch. It comes the other way. And there he is around the end. And he gets loose for some yardage. That's Eddie Herman. He's also a senior. He goes 5'5", 150 pounds. But more importantly, he moves the yard markers. The chains are moving forward. And roughly speaking, let's call it at the 40-yard line. First and 10 for the Riders. Clock moving here with 7:22 left in the first quarter. And finishing up here with the defense, Chihuahua, number 50, maybe he'll come back in. But 77 is Vicente Godinez. Number 60, Mario De La Rosa for Lincoln. We'll get the rest of their starting defense in a moment. Riders with the ball. Cortez, fullback, is right behind them. It comes the other way. Goes to Quesada. Breaks. Oh, misdirection. Still going. Oh, he's going to head down to the 30-yard line for a 20-yard gain.
Broken by number 5 from Lincoln.
And number 5 for the Tigers are going to give him credit for the stop.
He picks up the first down.
And that would be Yahir Contreras. He's offense outside linebacker. Another first down for the Riders. So looking at the running backs, number 2, of course, Quesada. Number 3, Herman. And number 9, looking for a roster change here, but it could be Alexander Arroyo wearing number 9 in gold. Handoff. Let's see, where did it go? Around the right end, and it looks like that was
with the carry.
Arroyo. Yes, he's switching numbers with the gold jersey this week. And he will be wearing number 9 tonight. Dana, let's call it, where's the yard marker? It looks like it's down. Ball spotted at about the 32-yard line. Check that. Second and 9, a long 9 here. Two new backs in there for Coach Parral and Roosevelt. Arroyo still at fullback. Here we go now. Number 5 has it. Got followed his blockers. paid the price, so he took a big hit. But that was number five, Jared Andrade. He's a junior, 5'10", 200 pounds.
It'll be third down, about five.
Third and five. Picked up about 3 yards or 4 yards on that carry. Back in the game is number three, Herman. Eddie's his first name, and he's going to take out number 25 for the Riders. That was Johan Alfaro.
Third down.
Riders coming onto this side of the field now for the first time. Cortez pitches to Herman, followed his blockers, found a seam, and he's going to drive forward. Good yardage on that pickup. Chains keep moving. It's going to be first and 10 from, let's call it, the 21-yard line. Roosevelt Rough Riders on their first possession in drive mode here. Picking up first downs, of course, on the ground with this double wing formation. Cortez, a quarterback, number one. And Cortez comes in at 5'8 as quarterback. In formation, pitch, there he goes, sweep right. Number four with the ball. And he gets credit for the carry. That's Alan Ortiz. He's a freshman, 5'6", 170. So Coach Parral and the offensive coordinators here huddling up here and looking to give other players opportunities as they maintain possession here on this drive that began roughly at, we'll call it, the 25-yard line. Chewing up some of the clock here as we are now looking at 6 minutes and 15 seconds left in the first quarter of play. Cortez with Herman, number three. Arroyo, number nine. And number two, Quesada, his running backs. And there was the, let's see, they went forward. Looks like there might have been Arroyo with the carry. Cortez doing a nice job with his sleight of hand because the fullback is right behind him. A yard, not even a yard behind, half a yard, and then all of a sudden he may be the first man through with the ball. Defense for the Tigers. Try to get you the rest of their lineup here. Number 80 is Cesar Castellanos. 55 is Nathaniel Luna. 52, Ryan Lucio. 22, Andre Watkins. And number 10, Dominic Lopez. We've given you Jose Cova, number four. Also on defense at cornerback. Riders, double wing formation. Handoff, look out, ball got loose. It's on the floor. And Blancarte picks it up. Fumble, and getting wrapped up was number five. And the defender was right on him. Andrade had no chance to tuck the ball where it should have been. It was carried off to the right side of his elbow, tucked underneath, and that's where the defender struck and popped it loose. So good defensive stop there by the Tigers as the Riders were near the inside the red zone with their first possession. Lincoln's second possession of the game. And out of the shotgun, Watkins, look out, he's got room. He's a big package. Goes right, cuts left, and then he's brought down by a host of tacklers.
Penalty on the play.
Uh-oh, penalty.
22 for Lincoln, close to midfield.
Watkins showing what he can do in open field, but there's a penalty flag down there by the crew chief. And he looks like one of his side judges or back judge. Looks like it's holding.
Penalties against Lincoln.
Lincoln's going to be bothered by some penalties here in the first quarter. In each of their possessions, they've been tagged with a holding penalty. It's going to move the ball back. So it's going to deny Watkins some big yardage. He ripped off about 25 yards on that carry. And we recall Andre Watkins in 2019. He was a terror as a sophomore. He was really, really doing well as a sophomore. And, of course, COVID last season took everybody out. Ball's over here on the left side of the field. Running play or pass number completed. Three. Number three on the reception. And let's give you his name for Lincoln. Number three will be Jaden Rattay. Jaden Rattay. Here we go. Pass. Caught. Oh, he was hit. Andrade playing some good defense. Making up for that fumble. He's playing excellent defense here. He broke up that big gainer to number 11. That was a Joshua Sosa. Over here, wide out to the right, to the far right. Number 11 for Lincoln. Plancarte, number 7. And behind him, we now see number 2 for the Tigers. Plancarte looking left. And it's going to be incomplete.
Pass is incomplete.
Looked like it might have been intended for number 4. That was Jose Cuova, C-O-V-A. Jose is a 5'7", 140-pounder. He's a senior, cornerback and wide receiver. Brings a fourth down for the Tigers. Second possession. And a second punt. Let's see, Watkins will punt. He's back. Number 5. Oh, it's going to be a very, very poor kick. It might bounce back towards Lincoln. It does. And you can see the nose of that football was just drilling down, looking to hit the field and then bounce back. So that's going to be a very, very poor punt by Watkins. It'll give Roosevelt excellent field position inside the 50-yard line. And roughly, we'll call it at the 45. First and 10 for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Second possession of the game for the Riders. And let's see what Coach Parral and his coaching staff will send out here on this series. Let's see who the running backs will be. Arroyo's number 9. And Arroyo he's a big, big player. And Arroyo is 6 foot, 250 pounds. He's only a junior, playing fullback. Right behind Cortez, the quarterback. Quesada on the right side. There's movement, and it goes. Check that. Quesada with it. Hey, broke some tackles. And still on his feet. Down again to the 23. Looks like the ball may have popped loose. But was he down? Let's see if they rule it a fumble or not. Or is there a penalty flag anywhere on the field? We're not sure. They're coming back with it, though. Holding against the Riders, that offsets the big gain there. So both teams are mirroring each other. Second possession and another second, we'll call it penalty. Similar to what the Tigers were penalized for. And clock now is down to 4 minutes and 9 seconds. It stopped on the penalty. East LA Sports Scene Productions and EastLASportsScene.com bringing you tonight's high school Friday Night Lights game here from Roosevelt High School. Football is in the air all over the city. High school, college, and professionals. We all know those teams, so here we go now. Let's focus on high school now. Pitch, it goes to 25, breaks a tackle. Oh, still on his feet. And Cova tries to bring him down from behind, and he does, but not before Alfaro. 5'10", 175-pounder. He's a junior. And he just was rolling on a big 25, 30-yard gain there, a big gainer, as they would say in the terminology of football. Huge play by Alfaro. And double wing formation sometimes. Both double wings are not at a 45-degree angle facing each other. We saw one of the wing backs deep on the line, just behind the line of scrimmage. So that broke that sequence.
Don't score yet.
And we're down at the 3:31 mark for a timeout. And with that, we will step aside for a quick break ourselves. This is East LA Sports Scene Productions and EastLASportsScene.com bringing you Roosevelt versus Lincoln in a non-conference game. We'll be right back. And we're almost ready to come back here. Whistles have sounded, both teams back onto the field. And Roosevelt Rough Riders adding to their touchdown totals. Unofficially, we have them with five. And none for the Tigers thus far in the contest. This is the second drive of the ball game for the Riders. Ball control extremely critical here. Cortez, a quarterback. Handoff, Herman. Goes around in and cuts back upfield. And he's going to get it down, let's see, for about a 4 to 5 yard gain. It's going to bring up second and five.
Number three, Eddie Herman with the carry.
So Coach Parral shuffling in and out his players. There goes Quesada, number two. You'll see him quite a bit. Number three, the low numbers are key for you to remember the ball carriers. Number one, a quarterback, James Cortez. Number two, Julian Quesada. Three is Eddie Herman. Four, Alan Ortiz. And five, Jared Andrade. So very, very easily to remember those numbers. Pitch. And here goes Quesada spinning and driving forward. Picks up another yard, a couple of yards.
Quesada wrapped up by number five from Lincoln, short gain.
And the clock is winding down. And we're inside the 3 minute mark. 2:55 left for the first quarter of play. Andrade out. And Alfaro back in, 25, is also a threat to carry that ball for Roosevelt. There you see the double wing, 45-degree angle facing the line. Oh, there you saw Quesada move forward. Alfaro with the carry. And he gets down near the goal line. Beautiful hole there made up, opened by the offensive line. We need to give you the offensive line for Roosevelt. 55 is the center, Butron. We have 50, Ibarra. We have Cerezo, number 56. Perez, 54, and Cueva, 75. And Cueva comes in a very big package. He's a junior. And Cuevas comes in at 5'11", 300. Cuevas, 75 for the Riders. Knocking on the door of opportunity and of scoring for the Riders here on the Tigers 1 to 2 yard line. Oh, movement. Offsides against Lincoln. And let's see, half the distance to the goal. Crew chief signal Lincoln jumping. And there's a whistle to resume action. Riders break huddle, walk up to the line, and there they are, ready to go. Back in is Arroyo, number nine, at fullback. Another whistle. Illegal procedure. He was already set and then moved. But for the double wing, there must be some type of a rule where if they're set, you can't move after a certain amount of time has elapsed. So, 5 yards further away, another penalty added up against the Riders. Third penalty of the game unofficially. They break huddle, here they come back up. Arroyo, number nine at fullback. Andrade, number five. And number two, Quesada. Andrade in motion. Cortez has it. Oh, no, no. Someone moved. The ball had not been snapped yet. Let's keep our eye on the crew chief in the white hat. And it looks like the left tight end came out of the three-point stance. And that's why Lincoln was then able to cross over the line of scrimmage. Another penalty. Ball's pushed back another 5 yards. First down, that's a good sign of things. First and goal. Cortez Herman. Herman has it, and he gets stacked up. In there on the stop, number one for Lincoln. Give him credit on the stop.
Stop by the
number one for Tigers is Karan Johnson. It's going to bring up second and goal. Roosevelt in their all predominantly gold uniforms with the gold helmet. Cardinal and gold SC colors. Many people will call Cardinal a maroon color, but it's Cardinal as well. So Cortez, Arroyo, Quesada, and Herman in the backfield. Oh, movement. And let's see the crew chief.
That sounds the end of the first quarter.
Before the snap, time had elapsed. And there it is. The first ending, or the first quarter, has come to an end with the score up on the board, 0-0. And we will now see where Roosevelt will switch sides of the field. And they will head down to our right, which will be the southern end of the stadium here at Roosevelt. Again, masks are required for all in attendance under the COVID guidelines in public and safety and public health under the CDC and the federal, state, and local jurisdiction here under COVID, as we still are in the pandemic. Dealing with the Delta variant. It's been very, very strong here in Southern California. So, Roosevelt with their possession of the ball. Have an excellent opportunity here. Let's see what Coach Parral will call here. As you see him out on the field, they're talking to the crew chief. He's going to walk down the middle of the field and ask for the interpretation of his running backs. Because this may be the first time that this official has worked a double wing, is maybe not familiar with the settings of the running backs. So Coach Parral really wanted to make sure that he's not giving his running backs bad information. So you saw him there taking the timeout. And then now we see head coach Gabriel Cotero for Lincoln also making an inquiry to the official. And there we go. He's had his say with the referee. And now back to action. Here comes Roosevelt back on the field along with the Lincoln Tigers. Backs to the wall here. And we'll set the table. Second down and goal.
Second and goal from about the nine.
Herman, Arroyo, and Quesada. Cortez rolls out. Oh, he got hurried. And he was knocked to the ground, so he got blitzed in there by Plancarte and also Johnson. But the pass was intended to the wingback, and it was incomplete. Clock stops, 11:55. That play took 5 seconds. And a penalty, though. Keep an eye on the crew chief. Oh, personal foul. Unsportsmanlike off face mask. That should be half the distance to the goal on the face mask. And it could have been on the rush that they brought when they brought down Cortez. Number one, there he is, going back in again at quarterback. Number one, James Cortez, he's a senior, 5'8", 180 pounds. And here we go, back to the action. Same formation, handoff. Oh, he gives it to Arroyo, straight up, dive. And let's see where they mark the ball.
Hand it off to number nine, Arroyo.
And it's going to bring up now third. He did not score, so they're knocking again at the door of opportunity for the first touchdown of the game. Clock running now, 11:28 in the half. Game number two for the Roosevelt Rough Riders, looking for a victory over the Northern League representative, the Lincoln Tigers from Lincoln Heights. Pitch, here we go. Alfaro, he breaks in. Oh, the touchdown off tackle. A short touchdown run for Johan Alfaro. Touchdown Roosevelt. And they get the first score of the game. As they were able to control the tempo, control the ball. And on their fourth and fifth possession here, check that, third possession, it was a very long drive that got them into the touchdown zone here. As they added on a few more first downs and give them a total of six thus far in the game. Going for the two-point conversion. Quesada moves up to the line of scrimmage. Pitch back to Alfaro again. Followed his blockers, and let's see if he's close.
25 again.
And he's good. Alfaro is golden for the touchdown. And the Roosevelt Roughriders take the lead here, 8-0, with 11 minutes and 12 seconds left in the first half. The Roosevelt Rough Riders now, special teams will come on. And they will take the field here. Coming to you here on a very beautiful day here in sunny Southern California. Bringing you high school football Friday Night Lights. So Alfaro gets credit for all 8 points by the Riders, and they're going to get set to kick off. And again, score came at 11 minutes and 12 seconds into the second quarter. And let's see, special teams are on and looking at number, 20. I'll check that, number 18. Coach Parral sends in number 18 as Gabriel Gomez. He's a junior, 5'9", 180 pounds.
Number seven and number three.
And Plancarte is back, number seven, along with his teammate, number three. That's going to be Jaden Rattay, R-A-T-T-A-Y. In twin formation there to receive the kickoff. Let's see what Gomez can do here on his first kickoff.
Number 18, Gabriel Gomez.
His second kickoff of the game. Teeing it up right now. And doesn't have quite the angle he wants. So going over to help him out is number 40. That's his teammate. That's James Trujillo. Number 40. Okay. Ball is a 90 degree placement straight up. Nose to nose. Straight up. Perpendicular, there it is. Kickoff is going to be low on the ground. And Lincoln will down it right there. Covering the punt was, or the kickoff was number 17 for Lincoln. And we'll get you his name here on per their roster. That's Johnny Castellanos. So Plancarte back in the game, is in the game here at quarterback. And give you his formation. He's out of the shotgun now, all alone in the backfield. Wideouts, triplets on the left side, and twins on the right side. There's a snap, goes right. He's got it to Watkins, he's a big back. He's a punishing runner, and he will gain yardage.
Complete to number 22.
About 12 yards on the pass.
Picks up
Andre Watkins from Plancarte. Ivan, his first name, number seven. Number one is Karan Johnson here in the near slot. Number three, Rate on the left side. Fake hand now, Plancarte again. Finds his receiver. Still going. Oh, look out, number 11. He's run out of bounds, deep in the secondary, around the 30-yard line. And that was Joshua Sosa. Quick strike offense here for Coach Cotero. Gabriel is his first name at Lincoln. Tigers in possession, another first down, back to back. Watkins has it. Misdirection, Still going. Again, he's a very, oh, ball got loose. Got punched away. And looks like one of the Roosevelt tacklers. Yes, he punched it out. Oh, good play there. Looked like it might have been number three, Herman, or number two, Quesada. But a turnover. A big turnover that Roosevelt would gladly take, but Watkins was punishing the defense there, as you saw him lighting up, but not after two first downs were picked up in succession by Lincoln. And that was their third possession of the ball game. Unofficially, we say always unofficially. Coming to you from Roosevelt High School, brand new facility here for Roosevelt, and it's still in progress. But the new gym is open for business and a new administration. And then we're going to take a timeout here. Lincoln going for a timeout with 10:38 left in the half. We'll be back in just a moment. This is East LA Sports Scene bringing you high school game of the week, Roosevelt Rough Riders taking on the Lincoln High School Tigers. Okay, and we're going to bring you some of the other games that are being featured tonight across the LA Unified School District, LA City Section, Garfield, at Canoga Park tonight. And we'll try to get you as many final scores as we can here as we go through either Scorebook Live or Max Preps. Good resources for bringing you up-to-a-minute high school scores here as we are now into week number two of the high school football season. Riders set to go after recovering a fumble. And there is a pitch. It looks like it's going to Quesada. And he rolls all the way to the right. Yes, Julian Quesada. Two touchdowns last week against Mesa's. Excellent runner, Julian Quesada. We'll give you 100% each and every carry. Brought down there by a host of Lincoln Tigers. And as we mentioned, we'll get you as many of those players as we can when we spot them. Okay, here we go. Back to the action. 7:53 left in the half. Roosevelt 8, Lincoln 0. There's movement. Looks like the Tigers may have hopped forward. And looks like it was Michael Ruiz, number 71. Again, front four, Ruiz, 71. Florida, 54. Lucille, 52. Luna, 55. Santiago, 75 for Lincoln. Plancarte in the defensive secondary. Plancarte, Watkins, Kova, and Johnson. We're missing two other players there. We'll try to find them, their names out for you shortly. Pitch, here we come this way. And it looks like that might have been number three. That was Herman.
Three, Herman with the carry.
Yes. And we'll try to get you the other two Lincoln players. Let's see if we have number three on the left side is Rete. On the far side, and that's Sosa, number four. But we also have number one, Karan Johnson, on end spot for Lincoln. Tightly bunched here on the line of scrimmage for the Riders out of the double wing formation. Pitch, here we go. Number four got the carry, and he got the call. Alan Ortiz, freshman.
Ball given to number four.
Very good run there. Followed his blockers.
Picks up about four. It'll be second down, about six.
And they move the yard markers just a little bit. Let's call it second and six. 77 for the Lincoln Tigers. We're going to need to give you his name. We just saw him as being in the ball game. That's Vincent Godinez. Pitch. Here we go the other way. Oh, look out at the 50, 40, 30. Andrade. Are there any flags? Are there any flags? That is the question. There is one. There's a flag. Right there, we'll call it at about the 41-yard line. They're going to wave it off. Oh, holding. Oh, my goodness. Roosevelt. Second holding call, but this one hurts very badly because it was on a touchdown. Oh, my goodness. Coach Parral needs to get an explanation from the crew chief. And that is a huge penalty. Holding on a touchdown. Would have called it a... Let's call it a 60-yard run. Line of scrimmage roughly was at the 40. And heartbreak hotel there for the Riders. Score gets called back. Holding penalty. Second, third of the game for Roosevelt. So call that one back. But you saw Andrade with some speed. Once he got into the secondary, there was nothing to stop him. And again, making up for that fumble he had late in the first quarter. Riders with the ball. Andrade's call, number called again. Oh, good tackle.
Number five.
And number eight in on the stop for Lincoln. That's Anthony Ochoa. He's a sophomore, 5'5", 155 pounds. So those are some of the other players we had not called yet for Lincoln. Ochoa's in there. Number eight is also in there. Yes, Anthony Ochoa, number eight. Looks like he's in the secondary, playing one of the up-close defenders in secondary because of the wing tee. Herman trying to follow his blockers and does not get very much.
Number three, Herman, wrapped up.
Okay, number 17 in on the stops. That's Johnny Castellanos for Lincoln. Again, we got Castellanos up front for the Tigers.
Second down and 10.
And let's see, let's call it second and 10. Butron over center. Or is the center, and behind him, of course, is Cortez. Behind him, Arroyo. Herman in motion, pitch, it comes the other way to Ortiz. Oh, he's dropped in the backfield. Oh, he snuffed that out nicely. Alan Ortiz dropped for no gain. Going to bring up third. And we've got third, and let's call it unofficially 12 for the Riders. At about the 40-yard line. A couple of substitutions come in for the Riders. Number 10, Carlos Vasquez. He's a running back. On the right side. Pitch to Vasquez. Look out, he's trying to get it around on a sweep. And he runs out of room, and he gets only back up to the line of scrimmage. So, good try, but he couldn't put the brakes on and do a misdirection and come back the other way. The Tigers were in hot pursuit over there, led by Karan Johnson, number one.
No gain.
And also number 18, Tyler Rosales. He was also in pursuit for the Tigers. That's going to bring up fourth, and let's call it 10. Special teams in for the Riders. Back in punt formation will be number 18, Gabriel Gomez.
Get to punt number 18.
And the Riders don't have all 11 players in yet.
Number three and number four.
And a whistle. And Coach Parral had no choice but to call for timeout since the Riders were not set at all 11 positions. And at 5:17, another timeout here. This is East LA Sports Scene Productions. Go to our website at eastlasportscene.com where you will find this game being shown on YouTube, on our YouTube channel. Okay, as again, it's a live but to videotape. And it is the 27th day of August as we get ready to close out another month here in the calendar for 2021, but a much different year than last year. We have in our rearview mirror now COVID 2020, and it was just a disaster. And again, a very, very terrible situation for the entire country as many families suffered the loss of a loved one. And again, went across the entire nation. And again, after things started to calm down, there was a new player in the game, and they were calling him the Delta variant. And that variant is still with us, causing a lot of grief. Okay, back to the action. And here's Gomez waiting for the long. Oh, it's over his head. Oh, look out, it's a problem, and he's going to dive on it. And this is going to give Lincoln excellent field position. So a big miscue there by special teams. And it puts Lincoln in sweet field position on that miscue. So a fumble by Lincoln and then a bad snap on a fourth down punt by the Riders to kind of level things off. So other than the score, it's 8-0 in favor of Roosevelt. Here come the Tigers with Plancarte. Very accurate passer when he gets on rhythm. And here's Watkins. Oh, just slamming forward with authority. And dropping him down there in the secondary was Andrade. But he picked up a huge yardage. Let's give him about 7.5 yards on that carry. Oh, ball's on the ground. Oh, still loose. Oh, and the Riders get it back. Placarte on a bad snap. And he did the best he could, but he just couldn't. Like a shortstop or second baseman had his hand on it, but he couldn't control it, and it skipped further away until it was there for the offering, and the Roosevelt Rough Riders jumped on it, as they should, recovering a fumble. So two big plays there.
And out comes the in terms of offense,
turnovers.
Just under 5 minutes.
So two fumbles.
Half.
Costly here for the Tigers. And we had a fumble earlier by the Riders and then a bad snap on fourth down. So turnovers have really been even thus far for both teams. But we're still in second quarter play. Here come the Riders. Back in possession. Double wing formation. And there is a handoff. Looked like it went to number 34, who's in the ball game for the Riders. And we're not going to be able to identify him here on the roster. Number 34 for Roosevelt.
Loss of about 3 yards.
Loss of three.
13.
Andrade goes in for Alfaro. And Alfaro did a lot of the damage for the Riders earlier in this period when he scored on a 4-yard sweep and then punched in the 2-point conversion. Oh, there's movement. Flag goes down. And let's see what the official will call.
Penalties against Roosevelt.
Looking for the white hat. We do not see him. Looks like he might have come off of the field. Oh, no, he is to our left. We checked that. We stand corrected. He is on the field. I was looking at the back judge, but the crew chief is always behind the offense. Pitch. Goes the other way. And there is the ball carrier, Andrade, brought down by Plancarte.
Andrade with the carry.
So the quarterback for Lincoln, Plancarte, very active on defense. Clock moving. Ortiz comes back in now for Andrade. Riders a walk up to the line of scrimmage. Cortez at the controls. Arroyo behind him at fullback. Handoff, pitch, check that to Ortiz. Nothing. Good tackle in there. Rate, number three, in on that stop. Coming in from his secondary. Check that on his defensive end spot. And hobbling off the field is number 54 for the Riders. And that is Freddie Perez. And now the new unit goes in for special teams. Again, fourth down. Let's see if Gomez will be able to handle the snap. Let's see who's going to be at the in the long snapper position here. Vasquez along with Alfaro and Andrade forming the blocking line. And there's Gomez, kicks it to his left. Oh, it's picked up on the fly. And there's no one there down the left side. Still going. Oh, coverage broke down there for the Riders, and Rate just picked it up. It was a low, not a line drive, but a blooper, so to speak. It didn't get very high, it didn't get very long, but just long enough for him to pick it up on the fly and then move 20 yards before any tackler was in front of him. So special teams doing his job there for Lincoln. Again, excellent field position for the Tigers. Seems like they've been in the red zone here for several drives, but they've been unsuccessful in scoring. Watkins got the call. And in on the stop, number 51. That's a Guillermo Vasquez. He's a linebacker. He's a sophomore, 5'10", 230. Tigers now. Shotgun for Plancarte. Watkins found a hole. And he's driving towards the goal line. Brought down there by two tacklers. No huddle offense. It's quick strike for the Tigers. Trying to keep Roosevelt off balance. Plancarte. Watkins went over his left tackle. He's going to be close. Can't tell from here, but let's see, he's going to be near the 2-3 yard line. Can't really tell from here.
Timeout call on the field. Timeout.
Looks like Roosevelt may call a timeout to talk things over. Yes, they do. Coach Parral says, timeout, guys. We need to talk it over. And let's see what Coach Cotero does. As we give you some of the coaches here for Roosevelt, assistant coach Ernesto Seca. And we have also Roberto Ortiz and Miles Tavares for Roosevelt. And let's see, for Lincoln, assisting coach Gabriel Cotero, we have Steve Silva, Daniel Jimenez, and Victor Menchaca. Also, Marty Martinez, Carlos Flores, and Caleb Cabrera. The same surname as yours truly. So here we are. Back to the action. Here come the Tigers. They're hungry. They're eager to try to tie this ball game up. Lincoln in white with the gold helmets. Plancarte to his right. Watkins. First name Andre. Plancarte has it on a keeper. Looks like he might have just got over the line. And he does right off his right tackle. So from 2 yards out. Coming at 1-19 left in the first half. Lincoln puts up six. Plancarte over right tackle. Let's see, now they're going to try to match it with a two-point conversion. And there's the play, and let's see. Does he get in? Yes, he does. is Andre Watkins for the two. And we have ourselves a tie ball game at 8-8.
First half, all squared up, 8-8.
And let's see how the last minute and 19 seconds will be played here. And Roosevelt will have the kickoff when we resume play. Special teams back on the field. So finally, the Tigers able to penetrate the Riders' defense. Again, due to a special teams fourth down punt return by Ratte. And he just gobbled up the yardage and put the Tigers in excellent field position down at, we'll call it, about the 20-yard line near the red zone. As the wind and the breeze start to pick up here in Southern California. So a very hot 91-degree day to a nice little chilly, breezy evening here in East Los Angeles in Boyle Heights. Here's a kickoff. It's going to go end over end to the right side. It's picked up here. And it's, look out, Ortiz. Ah, special teams in there. Number 12, Marvin Gomez in on the stop. Got himself credit for a tackle. And with 1:10, here comes the Riders back out. They're again showing the double wing formation. However, there's a wrinkle to it, and that both double wings are not permanently stationed in the backfield. At some point in the cadence, one of the wing backs goes up to the line of scrimmage, and that could be why the officials are calling or have called so far in this ball game.
Make sure you are not crossing over.
A lot of offsides.
By the letter K on the fence.
So here we go now. Rider ball pitch. And ball carrier was Andrade. And he picked up maybe a yard or two. Clock moving now. We're inside of a minute. Clock is running. 45 seconds left in the half. Eight to eight now. We have a tie ball game here. Northern League versus the Eastern League. Roosevelt in the Cardinal in gold. Lincoln in white. Gold helmets. There's Alfaro. And he stopped in there. Let's give credit to Watkins in on the stop. Clock moving now. Just 20 seconds. That could be the final play of the first half.
To a first down. It'll be third down and about one.
Third and one for the Riders. They're going to have to hurry up with 10 seconds left for the final play. Quickly now, Cortez will need to get the snap off. He does. And it's a misdirection. Oh, and going nowhere.
That sounds the end of the first half.
That was hit him on. He got stopped for a loss on the carry. And that will do it for the first half of play. 8-8. We're going to take a break, and possibly we'll see if we'll bring you the halftime program by the Roosevelt Rough Riders.
Visit your concession stands.
Cheer.
Drinks and some snacks available.
Okay, and song. Okay. Don't go away. Come back, take a break, and we'll see you in just a few more minutes during or after the intermission. Okay. Give me the cue. And here we are, ready to bring you the halftime entertainment from the Roosevelt. And here we go now for the halftime entertainment, introducing the Roosevelt High School song and dance and cheer. Let's go. So what we might have to do is put in a microphone so they can hold it. So I'll figure that out. Okay, we are back. The Roosevelt Rough Riders have broken through the barrier, as you saw at the southern end of the stadium, and they are all set to go. And we start from scratch all over again. And this time it's going to be for the victory, or it will have to be a defeat. And who knows, maybe, don't think it'll end in a tie, but let's see what happens here. Both teams look to be equally numbered with the number of players on the roster and in terms of their athletic abilities, okay? We won't see the 6'5", 6'7", type players, nor the skill set position players that are at the very high end of the high school spectrum. But again, it's high school football nonetheless. High school football USA, East LA, whichever way you call it, it is still a game. And a game that many schools and many communities really, really love as a big important part of their lives and their communities. So we're just glad to be here for East LA Sports Scene, covering Roosevelt. We'll look at Wilson, we'll look at Lincoln, we'll look at Torres, and several other schools here in the Eastern League, as the Roosevelt will be part of that, along with Garfield. That classic will be coming up towards the end of the regular season. So we're just glad that we're bringing you high school football this year, 2021, where last year, of course, we were totally on lockdown, as we all learned and all know from a devastating pandemic that still is lingering on. We thought we had it under control, but nope, not quite. It's still alive due to the variant of the pandemic. The COVID-19 is now still basically COVID-20. And we're under the CDC, Center for Disease and Control, in the federal level, and state level, local level county, and local level city, under the public and health guidelines and safety guidelines for all citizens and residents of city and county of Los Angeles and beyond. So we're all set to go here. The clock is winding down, just a minute or so left before we start over again for the second half. But recapping the scoring, it all took place in the second quarter, when at 11 minutes and 12 seconds, Johan Alfaro broke through on a right side sweep for 4 yards and a touchdown for 6, and then came right back for the 2-point conversion, giving the Riders 8. And then as the half wore down, at 1:19 left in the half, Plancarte went on an off-tackle dive play for the touchdown, and then Watkins added the 2-point conversion. And in the second quarter, both teams were just playing turnovers with each other. Roosevelt turned it over on a fumble and a bad snap, and Lincoln turned it over on 2 fumbles. Okay. And, of course, the score now reads 8-8, and we're ready to go for the third quarter. And Lincoln will be kicking off to Roosevelt. So we hope you're enjoying tonight's presentation of high school football. Roosevelt hosting the Lincoln Tigers from Lincoln Heights. Northern League has come into the Eastern League.
Welcome back, everybody. Hope you enjoyed that great halftime show. Hope you got to the concession stand for your drinks and snacks. Here we go.
Okay, and the PA announcer leading all of the information is going out to the fans that are here on a very good turnout for Roosevelt. And you see across the way in the bleachers for the visitors, it's nearly packed over there across the way. Okay, ready to go here. Let's see who approaches the kickoff for Lincoln. And let's see who that is. The referee now will give the football to the kicker. It's going to be number 15. It's Miguel Chihuahua. We have a pair of brothers on the team, Danielle and Miguel Chihuahua, or cousins, not sure, but Chihuahua's a surname. Okay, back to receive for the Riders. Number 4, Alden Ortiz and Jared Andrade. Number 5, kick is heading towards Andrade. He's got it.
That's Andrade who gets the ball.
Hey, he's got a seam. Broke a tackle. And going to get up towards midfield on a beautiful kickoff return. Jared Andrade followed his blocker as he found a seam. But there's a flag, look out. It could hurt the Riders.
Against Roosevelt.
Okay, looks like there's an illegal block committed by the special teams on the kickoff return. Happened at about the 30-yard line. And let's see if we can pick up that signal in our official's chart. He went to the hips and then went up on top, signifying that it was going to be called back. Okay, nonetheless, major penalty because it denied a huge advance. Instead of the ball at the, we'll call it the 50-yard line, it's going to be all marched all the way back to the Riders. 15 or more. Let's see, approximately 15-yard line where the side judge is lining up. First and 10 for Roosevelt. Double wing formation. James Cortez at quarterback. Very tightly bunched. And Herman dives through the middle, tried to turn it upfield, but Watkins there with an ankle tackle. Stopped him and threw him off balance, but he fell forward for a couple of yards on the gain. It's going to bring up, let's call it second. And let's see where they have the yard mark. Is second and about 7. Gain of 3. Cova number 4 for Lincoln. 22 is Watkins. Number 8 is Ochoa, right there in the linebacking core. Andrade, wing formation, facing the quarterback. Drawn offsides. Big number 75 is the guilty party. And that will be Nicholas Santiago. 5 yards, so Riders get some real estate back. And it's going to bring up second, and let's call it about long 5, maybe long 4. Whistle sounding here by, let's call it the back judge, a referee, crew chief. Oh, it was the back judge that stepped in. And we're ready to go back. Arroyo at number 9 at fullback. Ortiz, number 4 on the right wing. And there's the whistle sounding play. Cortez. Counter move there by Ortiz. He got it and gets wrapped up by number 18 by Lincoln. That was Tyler Rosales.
first down.
And he got enough for the first down. So the Riders in possession here as we start the third quarter. Coming to you from the campus of Roosevelt High School here, located in Boyle Heights, East Los Angeles, California. East LA Sports Scene Productions bringing you this game tonight as our game of the week. And it will be on our website at eastlasportsscene.com. Videotaped live and going into the website in the internet. Alfaro in at the right wing, number 25. And he did not get it. We went the other way looking for the runner. And that was Andrade. And he gets helped up by his teammates. Maybe a gain of one, if that. Well, they give him two. They're generous on the carry. Second and eight for the Riders. Third quarter just underway. 10 minutes and 15 seconds left. 8-8. We have ourselves a tie ball game. Week number two. Depending on which directory you're going from, last week was week zero, and this week they're calling week one. But in terms of sequence, it's game one and game two. And going up the middle, looks like it might have been Arroyo on the call. Not much space between the quarterback and the running back. Or it could have been Alfaro. Andrade comes back in, number five. And going out was Ben Medina, number 80. Sometimes he's in on offense. I'll check that. Ben Salinas, tight end. He's a senior, 5'10". Okay, we got third down here for the Riders. Double wing formation. Herman got the call. Went left and tried to go right. Then he's gang tackled by Lincoln. Oh, just a mass of humanity there trying to stop the forward progress on a very, very small-sized runner. But nonetheless, he's earned his role as a running back and he's getting significant playing time, Eddie Herman. Cortez takes a knee here, giving the play to his teammates. And again, they move the chains. First down, a couple of first downs here to start the third quarter for the Riders. Ball control and possession will be big at the end of this game. Cortez gave it to his wing back, running from right to his left. That was Ortiz on the carry, number four. Getting familiar now with all of the running backs here for Roosevelt. Again, Ortiz, number four. Hedeman, number three. Quesada, number two. And number nine is Alexander Arroyo.
Second down and about six.
Second and six for the Riders. Coming up to the line of scrimmage. Alfaro on the left, lined up as a tight end. Arroyo at fullback. Herman gets the pitch. He's found some room. Oh, he scampers forward. Oh, nice balance there by Herman. And he's going to get the first down. So the Riders adding to their first down totals here in the second half. We unofficially had them for seven in the first half. That unofficially now nine in the game. Eight to eight is our score. And we are in motion here. Clock is moving. Boutron at center. Gives it to Cortez and Ortiz. Slipped one tackle, two tackles, and got a couple extra yards before he's brought down. Give him credit for some yardage gain there, positive, for Ortiz. Doing well. Roosevelt, again, not being dropped for losses. That's one good thing about the double wing. It's all pretty much bunched at the line of scrimmage, and there's no drop back passing, and there's no shotgun. So the runners basically are not there. You see them at least 1 yard from the line of scrimmage. Oh, look out. And that was Cortez. He bobbled it as he wanted to hand off. So he takes the loss.
But it'll bring up third down at about 10.
Third and 10, a loss of about, let's call it 6 for the Riders. Second and 10. Clock is moving now. 6 minutes and 21 seconds left in the third quarter. Lincoln High School in white. Roosevelt in the gold. Cardinal in gold. Cortez, handoff, Herman. Went right, misdirection, came left. Still showing balance. Balance and speed by Herman. Again, the specifics on Eddie Herman. He's a senior. 5'5", 150. I repeat, 5'5", 150. And you see he's getting a very good workout tonight, carrying the ball for the Riders. And a quarterback, James Cortez, senior, 5'8", 180. So, in terms of the mass of weight and dynamics on the runners, they're very small, but they're looking to find those holes made for them by their O-line. And it's going to be a timeout taken on the field by the Roosevelt Rough Riders. And we'll be back after the timeout. Again, giving time here for the East Los Angeles Business Source Center. We're one of our proud sponsors here on East LA Sports Scene. And they have been with us for the past 2 years and doing very well, as they say, for the community. And the East LA Business Source Center provides small business services and training to East LA entrepreneurs and small business owners at no cost. Call them today at 323-264-9020. That's 323-264-9020, Monday through Fridays from 9 a.m. 2-5 p.m. Turn your business idea into reality by contacting them now, the East LA Business Source Center, and it's funded by the City of Los Angeles Economic Workforce Development Department. Tell them you heard it here on East LA Sports Scene, and speak to Ruben Sanchez or Ralph Carmona. Back to the action. Here we go. Roosevelt, Andrade, deep behind the quarterback. Cortez keeps it. And he tries to nudge himself forward. Looks like the ball may have popped loose. But they may have ruled his knee was down. So it looked like it was fourth and short, or it will be fourth and short.
Behind that offensive line.
Actually, they give a first down.
First and
10. Another first down for the Riders. And leading the charge, you hear the stands. And the cheering section here for Roosevelt. They're getting into it. Another first down, and there's Roosevelt. Another handoff. This looks like Hedeman again on the right side.
Andrade
this time, number 5. It's positive yardage. Third first down of the drive for the Riders. They started on the kickoff and limping off the field now. Here comes Andrade. They're going to have to take care of him on the sideline. And he looks like he's in a little bit of pain as we gaze down at him from our press area here at Rough Riders Field. Okay, here we go now.
Second down and 7.
Second and 7 for the Riders. Herman, he gets the handoff. Oh, good ankle tackle. And there's that man again, number 22, Andre Watkins. Wrapped him up, brought him down for no gain. That's going to bring up third, and let's call it a long 7. Third and 7 for the Riders. Ortiz is back in, number four. Coming out is Herman. We have not seen Quesada. We're going to have to gaze down onto the bench to see if we can find him somewhere. Number two on his jersey. He may be out for an injury. We don't know yet. Alfaro, number 25, is in. That's a keeper. Roll out left. Cortez. He's got some room. Oh, he's going to be pushed out of bounds. Moncarte.
Quarterback
on quarterback. Flag is thrown there. Two flags that we see. Let's keep our eye on the crew chief. Personal foul. Against Roosevelt. That's going to bring it back.
Penalties against Roosevelt.
Both referees ruling the same infraction. It's going to be a major penalty. 15 yards. Looks like it could be attached to a player, a sportsman-like conduct of some type. So a big gain there by Cortez would have given the Riders a first down. However, it's ruled against them. They go backwards. Ball's going to be spotted at approximately, I want to say the 45. Can't tell with the yard marker. It's near the 50-yard line. We'll make it the 48-yard line.
Third down about 18 for midfield for Roosevelt.
Third and 18 for the Riders. Long way to go for a first down pitch. Inside handoff to Herman. He found a little bit of space and saw some daylight, but he got wrapped up nicely coming in there to stop him. Number two for the Tigers.
Number three, Herman.
Jacob Velasco.
Brings them back to the original line of scrimmage.
And it's going to be fourth and ten, back up to the original line of scrimmage for the Riders. Again, we have not seen Julian Quesada, number two. He got off to a very good start in the first half. And I do believe we see him now on the bench, sitting down. Quesada, number two, has now returned to the ball game. Riders in possession. Cortez. Oh, dropped it, pitched it now. Oh, number 18. Good footwork. And then he gets dropped. But he just got inserted into the ballgame there. Number 18 was the punter, Gabriel Gomez. I thought I recognized that number. He's a running back as well. Junior 5'9", goes in at 180. And that's going to bring up fourth down. Let's see if Gomez stays in for the kicking team. Yeah, we're coming up to the two-minute mark of the third quarter. 2:02 left. And number 11 is going to be called on. Nazir Reed, number 11, in punt formation. First time we've seen him. Oh, check that. It was not. It was first and 10. That fourth down miss. And that's Plancarte. Oh, big gain ripped off there by Ivan Plancarte. And no huddle here for the Tigers. Coming out with quick formations as Watkins takes a tackler forward for positive yardage. Arroyo in on the stop, number 9. And Watkins, number 22, he's a big, big running back. 6 feet, 220 pounds. No huddle offense for Coach Cotero. Man in motion. Rate gets it on a sweep. And he's ganged up there. Reed in on the stop, number 11, along with Alfaro. And you see the line, offensive line just gets right up to the line of scrimmage. Plays are called well in advance by Plancarte and Coach Cotero. Rate swings over to the right side. Number 3. gets into the slot. Blancarte, Watkins to his right behind him. Handoff he goes to Watkins. Good move there. Then Arroyo wraps him up. A good sidestep there to evade one tackler. But Watkins bringing it down to the defense again. Picking up where he left off in the first half. Blancarte diving straight ahead. Still going. And now finally wrapped up. Vasquez in on the stop, or one of the, makes the official hit, first hit, but he's writhing in some pain there. Number 10 on the ground. Carlos Vasquez. Slow to get up. And looks like they're going to have to call for medical attention. So it's going to be a timeout taken on the field. Official timeout.
That's the end of the third quarter.
Oh, check that. End of the third quarter. They all happen at the same time here. So no score in the third quarter. That's a repeat of the first half. And we'll be heading in here to the fourth and final quarter. So stand by with us here. We're going to see what happens to Carlos Vasquez in just a moment. This is East LA Sports League production of High School Game of the Week, Roosevelt versus Lincoln. Okay, we are set to come back. Friday Night Lights is happening again, and the east side of town is very, very glad and very happy to have their student athletes performing here for the student body and community and all of the fans here at Roosevelt High School. There you see the Lincoln Tigers in the red zone, threatening to take the lead as we begin the fourth and final quarter of this non-conference game. Lincoln out of the Northern League and Roosevelt representing the Eastern League. Blancarte, Ivan, his first name, number 7. Watkins and Rete in the backfield. Offset. Blancarte trying to get around right in. And he looks like he may have been run out of bounds at about, let's call it, the 7-yard line. No huddle of offense for the Tigers. Coach Cotero has coached them up about the series of downs, series of plays that he wants to run. More plays here for the offense, trying to wear down the defense.
First and goal
now for the Tigers. Watkins, the big package, just steaming his way forward. Very difficult to bring down Andre Watkins. Make no mistake about that. Again, 6 foot, 205 pounds. He's a senior. Very highly recruited. Oh, the ball hit the ground. Blancarte picked it up, but there was a whistle.
Timeout called by Roosevelt.
Looks like there's a timeout called before that snap. And they will come over to talk with Coach Aldo Parral. There you see him right on the field. But we have now noticed that Julian Quesada, number 2, has not returned to the lineup, not returned to the game. And we see him sitting on the bench there next to number 40 for Roosevelt. And there must have been some type of an injury sustained by the players. But number 40, let's identify him. And that will be James Trujillo, one of the tight ends, 5'11", 260. He's a junior. Okay. So, we don't know the true story there, but we're assuming it could be an injury. But he has certainly been one of the offensive threats for Coach Parral on offense. Two touchdowns last week in the season opener. Okay, knocking on the door of opportunity are the Tigers. Blancarte Watkins went left and then came back right. He drug a lot of tacklers, including Alfaro, along with number 20. Give him credit for one and a half stop on that. And they're right back at it. Again, no huddle for the Tigers. Third and goal, Blancarte. He wants to take it himself, looking for blockers. He's going to be gaining a couple of yards, positive. Arroyo in on the stop. Last man to get up off the pile.
Number 10, number 9, Vasquez. And Arroyo for the stop. It brings up fourth down.
And it's going to bring up fourth. He's denied the scoring opportunity as he had Watkins and Rate on his left.
Lincoln's lining up to go for it.
Lincoln wants to go. No field goal attempt. They want to go for it all. Plancarte, Watkins, and looks like he skips in. Oh, he only had to go for 2 yards.
Touchdown, Lincoln.
And they're going to give Watkins the score. It comes at 10:15 left in the game. And Watkins now, 2 yard touchdown run. And they're going to go for the two-pointer. And it looks like he may not make it. Stop before the touchdown or the goal line.
Score now 14-8 in favor of the Tigers.
And that was Watkins denied the two-point conversion. So we have ourselves a 14-8 ball game in favor of the Lincoln Tigers. So, possibly looking at a touchdown by the Riders would tie the score, and then they may elect to go for the single point after a touchdown, PAT, or a two-point conversion. That remains to be seen. So let's see what happens here. Special teams come on for both schools, and we're looking at number 15. That's going to be Miguel Chihuahua kicking off for Lincoln. Special teams up, and back to receive will be Andrade, number 5, along with number 4, Ortiz.
Number 5, number 4, Andrade and right.
Here it is. It's on the ground, picked up by Andrade. Straight up the middle. Goes right, goes left. Still nicely returned. All the way up to about the 45-yard line. Good position here to start the drive for the Riders. They trail now 14-8. And every possession, every snap is going to be big time for Roosevelt. They're in huddle now. And they break and they come out. Number 4, Ortiz, along with Herman, number 3. There's a snap to Cortez. Herman drops way behind, 5-10 yards deep. He gets a snap. Oh, he's got a run. He went left, right, and then cut back left.
Number 3,
Eddie Herman.
into Lincoln territory.
He's into Lincoln territory. Second and let's call it about two. Good pickup there. 8 yard blast there by Hedeman. You saw that he went from a wing back all the way to the I back on that formation. So it's a different look there by Coach Parral. And into the ball game comes number 13, Andrew Oliva into the ball game for the Riders. Cortez. Oh, movement. And here comes to Andrade. He's got room. Found the seam. Still going. 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown. Is there a flag?
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Riders. Looks like that was about a 35-yard blast on the right side over tackle on a sweep. As coach calls it, a toss sweep. No flags on the field. And there he is, Andrade, in for the score. Number 5, first name, Jared, J-A-R-E-D. He ties the ball game at 9:02 left in the contest. Let's see what Coach Parral does for the conversion. So the Lincoln secondary unable to keep up with the speedy Jared Andrade. Arroyo back in at fullback. Ortiz on the right, number 4 in motion, stops, goes back. Herman on the left wing back. Oh, Cortez runs into his own running back deep in the backfield, and that will end that play. And two-point conversion, no good. We have ourselves 14-14 tie again. Oh, as we compare to a boxing match, we're going deep into the last three rounds of the 12-round fight, and it looks like the bout has been called even thus far. So we have 9 minutes to decide or determine who may win this ball game. Coming to you from the home of the Roosevelt Rough Riders, members of the Eastern League taking on the Lincoln Tigers from the Northern League. We hope you're enjoying tonight's Friday night football contest here in Boyle Heights, East Los Angeles, California. Okay, there's the whistle. We're ready to go for Gomez, number 18 for the Riders. Ball falls off the tee. But the Tigers have a twin returners there with Rate, number 3, along with, let's see, number 7, Plancarte, Ivan, the quarterback. Very talented player. Ball's going to go over to the left. Line drive picked up. Number 10 has it. Yeah, he's going to be brought down. Not too much yardage on the return. And let's give credit to number 21 for the Riders, Miguel Arias. He's a senior, 5'8", 200. And for the Lincoln Tigers, returning it was Dominic Lopez, number 10. Again, quick strike offense set up for the Tigers. No huddle. So the Riders have to be ready to go after each and every play. Full backfield there for Plancarte. On his left is Watkins. On his right, Rate. Hand off to Watkins. And Vasquez in on the stop along with number 30. That's a Nicholas Soria. Penalty flag comes out at the end of the play. Let's see what the ruling will be. Keep our eye on the white hat, the crew chief. He's going to be informed by one of his crew members of the infraction. And here comes the relay of the infraction. Keep your eye on the white hat. Again, all referees masked up due to COVID by regulation. There you see the three are huddled. Now here comes the decision rendered by the crew chief. Uh-oh, targeting.
I don't think he's against Roosevelt.
And to held to the helmet. Let's see, that's a major penalty. And it's going to be marked off against Roosevelt. That's huge. Personal foul, and again, targeting pointed to the helmet. First down for the Tigers. They'll gladly take it. Watkins to the left, and Plancarte, quarterback dropping back, airs it out to the right side, connecting. Oh, look out, still on his feet, and then thrown out of bounds finally. And this number 11, that was Joshua Sosa. Big gainer there is Plancarte. We have not seen him drop back. He's definitely a very accurate passer. We learned that from watching him in 2019. Plancarte again, hand off to Watkins. Oh, beautiful tackle. Nicely done there. Let's see the Roosevelt Rough Rider, though. Slow to get up. Not taking the hand from his teammates. And they're going to have to come out and attend to him. And there you see the all players on the field taking the knee in solidarity with the injured player. But it was a great tackle. Couldn't have asked for a better effort made by the injured player. We don't know the number, but the medical team is running out there. You see the attendant with his black satchel, his bag. Let's hope that he's going to be okay, but he certainly didn't feel that he was ready to get up on his feet. So what we're going to do here in the interim, while they attend to him, we're going to take a quick break and come back on the other side in just a moment. This is East LA Sports Scene and East LA Sports Scene Productions bringing you the high school game of the week, Roosevelt versus Lincoln.
Go Riders, let's go! Let's go Riders, let's go to war!
Let's go! Touchdown! Oh, is he out of bounds? Will they have him in bounds? It was a pass play. Plancarte with a snap and a shotgun, and he found his receiver deep in the corner, and he was able to catch it just inside, and then Plancarte goes in for the two-point conversion. So coming in at
2-point conversion is good.
8:03 left in the game. Roughly, we'll call it a 20-yard pass play. From number 7, Plancarte, to the receiver. And he caught it right in the end zone, right in the corner before going out. So they pick up 8 points here, and they go back up on top. Score now reads 22-14. So again, we apologize on that situation there where they were tending to the injured Roosevelt player. He did get up and back on his feet. So good for him, and let's continue on now after the touchdown. Special teams are back on. but it was a great play. Sorry, we missed that. Our bad on that touchdown pass by Plancarte to his receiver. Back to kickoff. Number 15, Chihuahua.
Right and Andrade.
Right and check that. They're calling number 4 and 5. Okay, if it's Isaiah White, we have him with a different number. So our apologies again.
That's number 4, Isaiah Wright.
Wright has it. He's going to try and get out here to the right side. A good run back. So we apologize due to the roster that we were handed to at the beginning of the game. Number 4 reads Alan Ortiz. And the announcer's been calling it Isaiah Wright. So we stand corrected. And again, an administrative mistake. So Isaiah Wright, number 4. And I do believe they just swapped numbers. And we'll call Alan Ortiz number 6. Back to the game now. Here we go. Roosevelt trailing it by 8 now in the fourth quarter. Let's see what Coach Parral does here. Cortez has hit him on. Looking for blockers. Oh, he got leveled right there. Plancarte, number 7.
Carries the ball, picks up about 4.
So Plancarte putting his helmet in there, but you know, as they say, getting his nose into the middle of that play, and he stopped Hermann with a very, very hard tackle. But Hermann did pick up yardage positively on that carry. Second and 8 for the Riders. Cortez, handoff, Andrade, here he goes again, number 5, good positive yardage. In on the stop, number 22 was Watkins, along with number 17, Johnny Castellanos. So the Tigers going ahead there on roughly a 20-yard pass play from Plancarte to his receiver, who tiptoed and stayed in bounds in the corner of the end zone. Well-timed and well-executed play there by the Tigers. Roosevelt out of the huddle. Bouton is the center for the Riders, number 55. Daniel Butron. And here's Hermann. Watkins, the first man in on the stop, but Hermann has that way of gaining the extra yardage on the spin. His good pivoting has helped him immensely here. It's going to be first down here. First and 10 for the Riders. Again, the Rider running game, again, producing results over the course of the game. At least 10, maybe 12 first downs. And Lincoln, on their last two drives, have rallied to almost catch them in terms of first downs. Riders, double wing formation. Hermann drops into the eye back. He gets the call, and he's going to be double-teamed right there at the line of scrimmage. Oh, 54 in with a good tackle for Lincoln. And that's Carlos Flores. Carlos Flores in on the stop, 54. Again, the big front line of the Riders doing their job, no doubt about that. They have been busy.
Second down and 8.
And again, the double wing sacrifices the air game. You have not seen any passes from Roosevelt tonight. It's been done all on the ground, and they've managed to put up 14 points but they trail by 8 to the Tigers, 22-14 in the fourth quarter. Cortez at quarterback. Takes the snap, gives it to Andrade. Oh, he's busting out here to the right side. Oh, and Rete wrestles him down. And he could have broke that. Had he been able to get by Rete, he would have had another 5-10 yards easily because the secondary was not able to cover. First down here for the Riders. So the running scheme there with Andrade getting the majority of the carries has been producing well for Coach Parral. As we approach the four-minute mark here, left in the game. James Cortez, number one on his jersey at quarterback for the Riders. Herman goes deep into the backfield. Pitch, here we go, the other way, Andrade. Oh, and Plancarte is everywhere. Number seven, outstanding player for Lincoln. He goes both ways, offense and defense. And you can tell he is a player's player, a coach's player. He does not want to come out of the game. Second and seven for the Riders. They need to maintain possession here and try to punch it in to get close. They're going to need a two-point conversion to tie. 6 points or a touchdown will not matter that much if they are unable to score the two-point conversion. Hit him on the right side. And Andrade, now he drops it back into the I spot. Pitch, handoff, Andrade going over tackle. And he gets the call and gets a couple of yards. And Herman's helmet popped off for some reason. He's going to have to come out of the game for equipment. And going back in is Isaiah Wright, number four.
Third and three.
Big third down play here for the Riders as the clock is winding down into that dangerous two-minute mark. It's 2:30 left to go. Riders in possession. In at fullback, number 34. Oh, there's movement. Did the ball pop loose or not? Looks like the ball may have squirted loose. Oh, looks like the Tigers have come up with it. Let's see what the ruling is. Or was the ball already dead? Oh, they're going to give it to Lincoln. There's a fumble ruled. Oh, a misread there by the running backs or possibly with the alignment. And it results in a tremendous turnover for the Riders as they cough it up here, giving it back to Lincoln. And we're now coming up to the two-minute mark at 2:07. So bad break there for the Riders. Fumble. And here goes Lincoln with the ball. They're going to probably stick to the ground and pound game and try to run out the clock. So Lincoln now in control of their destiny here. Plancarte is a quarterback. No huddle offense for the Tigers. Taking some time here in between the play to get set. Plancarte has gone all the way quarterback for the Tigers. There he is. Watkins gets the carry. Oh, look out. And he is at the 50, 40. He's got space. Cuts it in, 30. And dropped down, finally. Looks like there was number three over there was Hedeman, along with number 11. That might have saved that touchdown there for Roosevelt because Andre Watkins certainly wanted to score. That was a read Nazir Reed at number 11. They were able to bring Watkins down once he cut back in. Huge gain, maybe 30 to 40 yards minimum for Andre Watkins, well over the 100-yard mark now. Plancarte just taking his time, barking out the signals, has it, takes the knee. And with 50 seconds left, that should be it. We don't know how many timeouts are left. Does it read one timeout left for Roosevelt? No, it's going to be Lincoln. As you hear the chants and the applause going from their stands on the far end of the Tigers rooting section, they have brought a lot of fans from the school, which of course is just not that far up the road in Lincoln Heights. And there it goes with 15 seconds left. You see the Tigers going into their celebration, their victory celebration for winning this game tonight with a final score of 22-14. Lincoln Tigers go 2-0, and Roosevelt will drop to 1-1 after week number two, or game two, in this 2021 series. And there you see the post-game salute from about 50 yards apart due to COVID. Again, COVID has been a big change for football in terms of the regular post-game celebrations, or salute, the Warrior salute, we'll call it, where they go through the 50-yard lines and shake hands. But they acknowledge the opponent and vice versa. A game well played. But as we mentioned, there will be a winner and there will be a loser. So what we're going to do here is do a post-game official sign-off here to conclude the game with the hopes of bringing in head coach Aldo Parral and possibly one or two of his players. We're going to wait and see, but there he is going to be giving the post-game speech to his players, and we will wait and see what happens. Okay, so that will do it for this edition of East LA Sportsy Productions for the actual game itself. 22-14 in favor of the Lincoln High School Tigers. They come out victorious, and we will see you next week for our next game on High School Game of the Week here on East LA Sports Scene Productions and EastLASportsScene.com. So take care, and we will hope to see you shortly. This is Rico Cabrera along with Frankie Robles and Ricky Siementhal, our production crew here on East LA Sports Scene.
And here we are now with our post game, and we're going to be speaking with head coach from Roosevelt High School, Aldo Parral. Coach, good to see you. And again, a very good effort tonight. Came out in the losing end, but nonetheless, preseason contest, you learned a lot, your players learned a lot. But your thoughts and your observations for tonight's game?
Well, first off, I want to say thank you, Rico, and East LA Sports Scene for being out here. Truly grateful that you took the time this evening to come out and cover Roosevelt High School. And, again, thank you again.
You're welcome, Coach. Appreciate it.
So, as far as tonight, you know, it was a tough loss. The kids, you know, we were really excited about this matchup. Mm-hmm. You know, Lincoln High School is a really good ball club. They're one of the top programs in the city.
Yep.
And Coach Cotero over there has done a great job as far as preparing his kids and just getting them ready. You know, mm-hmm. they had a great spring season, and you know, they just came out. You know, yeah. They came out and played some good football, and so, you know, just a lot of credit to Coach Otero and the Lincoln Tigers tonight.
And again, it was up in the air, and it was anybody's game, as you would say, until their drive, I think of a major penalty, gave them that extra yardage and a little extra stimulus to try to punch it in late in the game. So they knew a lot was on the line. But you guys were in the ball game the whole time.
Yeah.
Your thoughts on the way your offense performed? Again, we're looking at double wing, and you can contrast it from last year, as they say, 2019, where we saw the full season.
Yes.
But last year you had to make some adjustments because of the pandemic and COVID, and now you're in full stride, so to speak.
Yes.
Your thoughts on the offense and, of course, the defense doing very well as you progress, but
well,
offense.
You know, the kids pretty much, you know, we had some really good drives. We were really happy with the way we were moving the football. The problem, I think, was just a lot of mistakes. You know, we had some turnovers. I'm thinking we had maybe about 3 turnovers.
Yeah.
And, you know, it was at key opportunities. You know, we had a few penalties that we also had.
Mm-hmm.
We just shot ourselves in the foot too many times. And against a good ball club like this, it's a challenge. You know,
yeah.
You're not going to dig yourself out of that hole as easily as maybe if we would have played a lesser opponent.
Yeah.
So it was tough. It was tough, Rico. And, you know, I'm happy in some respects, right? But it's really difficult, or it's hard to swallow when you know, you could have, should have,
yeah.
Right?
Yes.
But at the end of the day, hats off to the Lincoln program. And, you know, it's a team that we could possibly see in the playoffs.
That's true.
You know, they're, and I think things would be a little differently at that point.
And the last thoughts, Coach, before I let you go to get back with the team, because we're going to interview a couple of the players.
Yes.
But full stride, full season now, fans are back, students are back, school is coming back,
yeah.
Near normal. We're not normal yet, but near normal.
Yeah.
Your thoughts on that? Having the kids, your students, and the players play in front of a regular type crowd and a home crowd at that.
Well, I'll be honest with you, Rico. The loss, as tough as it is right now, you know, that's what is in my right in front of me, right? But the reality is, when you compare to what the losses have been, you know, we lost, you know, Coach Dickey earlier in the year, and that was really difficult. And so when you look at what our real losses were in life.
Yeah.
Just having this opportunity, you know, hearing the fans, hearing the band, the cheer, you know, the roar of the crowd on some big runs, you know, that was great. That was great, you know, and so I'm really excited. I'm glad high school football is back. I'm glad Roosevelt is back on the field. And, it's going to be a little different, but I think every week it'll be an adventure, right?
Yes.
And so I'm hoping that the fans come out and enjoy a taste of Friday Night Lights.
Okay.
And, we'd love to have you. We'd love to have you.
Yes.
And we really, I think this is about as normal as it's going to get for a while. But thank you again, Rico.
You're welcome.
And our two guys, actually, I'll introduce them if you don't mind.
No,
our offensive player of the game is Jerry Miranda. Great game, number 5. And Andrade Miranda. And then we also had number 7, the defensive player of the game is Joel Morales.
Okay.
And we call him, his nickname is Chingon. So he had an awesome game.
Okay.
And so we're getting ready for next week. We're looking forward. We'll learn from our mistakes. We got Crenshaw coming down.
Okay.
So we're hoping that you as a fan base are able to get out here and get excited again.
Absolutely.
Next week's game will be on Thursday.
Okay.
Thursday at 7 p.m.
Okay.
Not sure if we're going to have a JV game, but we're hoping we do. But in the meantime, 7 p.m. Thursday against Crenshaw. And hopefully you're here.
Coach Aldo Parral, we thank you very much for your compliments and your support of us, to the community as well, and, of course, to Roosevelt and the schools in the Eastern League. We want to make sure all of our communities can watch their kids and their student-athletes play at some point. So we're going to try and distribute and share the love as much as we can, but we know we have a home here with you, Coach, and we want to thank you and De Perea and the administration for welcoming us here to do our high school's game of the week when we do Roosevelt. So thank you very much, Coach, and we look forward to seeing you here next week for Crenshaw.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Coach.
Everybody.
Take care. Jared, you are a powerhouse. You were basically the big package for Roosevelt, just like Watkins was the big package for Lincoln.
Mm-hmm.
You guys balanced each other out, but
yes,
you put on a very good performance tonight.
Thank
you got to be proud of your effort. Unfortunately, there's a loss, but that's just – part of the season, part of the game. Talk about your participation and when it came down to crunch time, what Coach Parral was trying to get the last drive in. But talk about the overall game that you played tonight.
Well, first, I want to thank you guys for coming to support us and watch us play. It's always a good game when you guys come watch us. But second of all, this is without our line, nothing would be possible without them. Mm-hmm. They always fight for us. They take hits for us, and we always have to do good for them taking our hits. But there's one drive where I got cramps, but I walked myself off, and I didn't think I was gonna go back in. But I fought it off. I stretched out, and when it was time to clutch up, I clutched up. Mm-hmm. I tried to put the team on my back. I tried to help as much as I can. As I scored the long run I did on the I think it was a I right.
Yep.
I followed my blocks. I hit the hole, touchdown, and then I just tried to do it again. I told them I wasn't over until what's up, Lou. I told our line to keep on doing what they're doing. Their blocking was amazing, mm-hmm. and without them, I wouldn't be able to do it.
Well, you guys again were very competitive. It could have went either way, and again at the very last drive where mm-hmm. the fumble looked like there might have been an offsides or there was a whistle or something, but then they went in and the guy came out with the ball mm-hmm. from Lincoln, so that was a big surprise. Yeah. I thought there was a penalty, but nonetheless, you guys were competitive. You were in front, leading in the game, but then they came back. So we called it up here, like two boxers in a 12-round match, and it was going down to the wire. But
a
great performance. You played in front of a big crowd.
Thank you.
And it was very good. Both sides had their their fans out, and Roosevelt football now two games, one and one, and you guys are learning each week.
Sir.
Talk a little bit about the chemistries thus far in the team.
Well, a lot of it goes through practice. We always try to make sure we get our little mistakes made, because what killed us today was our offsides, penalties on defense. It was mainly the little things that we had to fix. Without those little things, we would have won this game for sure.
Mm-hmm.
It was the little
mm-hmm.
penalties that killed us. The offsides, the targeting on one of our players.
Yeah.
It was just those penalties that killed us. It was just little mistakes that we had to fix, and when we fix that, we'll be good for the whole season.
Yeah, and I think it could have been a different ball game because of the touchdown that was called back on the holding. Yeah, that was yours, right?
Mm-hmm.
You had that one. But again, you guys were in the game, and you have a season that's going to be very tough.
Amazing season. It's
going to
be good.
Crenshaw.
It's going to be a good game against them.
Yeah, and then you got Garfield down the road, but there's a lot of good competition that you're going to be heading into. So the team's got to stay strong, stay together.
Mm-hmm.
So you're doing your part, and I'm sure the defense is going to be also doing their part. Anything you want to convey, anything you want to talk to or say to your family, your friends, mm-hmm. classmates that are watching?
I'd like to thank all the people that came out to watch us. Without them, it wouldn't be a good game. Then supporting us when we're on our ups and downs. They help us out a lot. Hearing them cheer for us, it helps us a lot. It helps us up, and we just want to make it look good for them. Without them, it wouldn't be nothing without them.
Jared Andrade, number 5, a very distinctive number. And again, you've had a very, very powerful game.
You.
Keep it up and keep doing well in school.
Yes, sir. Thank you,
okay?
guys.
And we're going to talk to your teammate now in a moment. Joel Morales, just a moment. Okay? So here we go. We're going to switch over, and now we'll talk about the defense. And Joel, quiero decirle, buenas noches, ¿cómo
buenas
estás?
Noches. Hey, man, pues tuvimos un juego muy difícil. Eran grandes jugadores y pues hicimos lo que pudimos. Tuvimos unos errores, pero así a veces pasa.
Yes, Joel answered that yes, it was a good game. They had some very good players and they're just good athletes, and they did the best they could here under the circumstances.
Sí.
And as you heard, como hemos escuchado ya de que los errores
sí.
cometieron ya por ustedes
sí.
que lo trazaron
sí.
en vez de avanzar.
Sí.
You know? Díganos ya en el partido hoy, ese jugador 22.
22.
Un corredor tremendo,
sí,
fuerte.
Es un buen jugador y
sí.
pues, no, pues que le vaya bien y.
Uh-huh.
Sí.
Y el quarterback,
sí.
el mariscal del campo, que
uh-huh.
no. Buen,
es,
buen
pues,
jugador
buen
también.
El jugador sabe moverse y pues hicimos lo que pudimos en la línea.
Uh-huh.
Y tuvimos unos errores, pero vamos a mejorar, tratar de mejorar en esta semana y. Pues,
okay.
Sí.
Y sus teammates,
sí.
¿cómo están ahorita ya después de sufrir ya este pérdida ya del juego? ¿Vas a hablar con ellos y tú sabes convivir
sí.
y con
sí,
ellos?
Pues, sí, la verdad ahorita yo creo que están como un poco tristes por la pérdida, pero pues son errores que a veces pasan y pues vamos a mejorarlo.
Okay. Sí. Quiero darle ya la chance ya de decirnos ya en inglés si quieres. How did you play in the game? Do you feel it was a very, very good game?
La verdad estaba muy difícil. Eran unos un equipo muy bueno.
Sí.
Y mi equipo también estaba muy bueno. Estoy orgulloso de mi equipo.
Okay.
Este, y pues eso es todo.
Okay, y la semana siguiente va a ser otro oponente muy fuerte.
Crenshaw.
Sí. Okay.
El jueves. Es un poco tiempo lo que tenemos de preparación, pero vamos a tratar de hacer lo mejor que podemos para poder ahora sí ganar.
Okay, Joel, muchísimas gracias por su tiempo. Quiero felicitarle ya de un partido ya buen jugado.
Gracias.
Bien jugado. Y suerte ya en el partido que viene, el día jueves.
Gracias. Okay. Gracias por venir y gracias a la gente que vino a apoyarnos. Y
sí,
gracias a todos.
Al contrario, y que le vaya bien. Okay. Nos vemos pronto.
Gracias.
Okay. That will do it, and I'm going to go ahead and just give a brief comment about what we spoke about. Joel was very, very in general and very, very particular about the game tonight and about the season, the Crenshaw next week, and he said they are learning, they're getting better and better, and it's early in the season, but they have a very, very good team. He's got a lot of faith and confidence in it, and they're going to do well. So, again, a loss is a loss, but they learned tonight, and they'll move forward. Okay? So, finalmente, Joel, en inglés, si quiere decir o no.
No, prefiero en español.
Okay. Ahora quedamos y vamos a terminar ya la entrevista.
Okay.
Que le vaya bien y nos vemos ya el día jueves entrante.
Okay. Gracias.
Gracias. Okay. And that will do it for this edition of East LA Sports Scene. We are closing out. Ricky Simmental, Frankly Robles, videographer. And yours truly, Rico Cabrera, doing the play-by-play. And we have also a big salute and thankfulness to Eric Sarney for helping us do our setup here tonight for the Roosevelt versus Lincoln game. That'll do it. And thanks for watching. And continue to watch EastLASportsScene.com and East LA Sports Scene Productions. Take care and stay safe, stay healthy. We will see you soon.